Hi, I'm Heidi Rader. I'm with Cooperative Extension Service. I'm here in the Georgeson Botanical Garden in Fairbanks, Alaska at the University of Alaska Fairbanks. Today is the spring and we're going to be talking about what we do in the spring, which is planting your garden and bed preparation. So what a lot of people do in the spring is they go rent the rototiller and they till their soil and turn it all up. That's okay, that's especially for a new garden, sometimes you need to rototill. But for an established garden, another way to do it is use what's called a broad fork. And this just gently aerates and loosens the soil, but it doesn't turn the soil. And the good thing about that is it keeps some of those microbial communities intact. And so it keeps them a lot happier. And they do things like break down nutrients and just keep your soil healthy. So it's best to have a rich ecosystem of microbes in your soil and not to break it down too much. So first you're gonna loosen your soil. Next, you're probably gonna add some type of fertilizer. If you're a home gardener, you can just sprinkle it on like this. Sometimes it's easiest to do before you plant. You can just sprinkle it and then rake it in. At the Cooperative Extension, we always recommend fertilizing based on a soil test. You can use organic or conventional fertilizer. You want to look for what the numbers say. So this is NPK, your nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium numbers. If these numbers are really low, there aren't a lot of nutrients in them. The higher numbers, the more nutrients are in your fertilizer. So maybe you could say it's a bigger bang for your buck. But organic fertilizers, the value is that they're going to release slowly throughout the summer. And you get a lot of trace minerals, but usually need to add more than one type of organic fertilizer. Blood meal, bone meal, and green sand will provide all your different numbers for you. After you fertilize, I like to add a little bit of organic matter on top of your bed. And it's really important to keep your seeds moist until they germinate or sprout. Otherwise, they're probably gonna die. So this allows you to more easily keep your bed wet. So add a little bit of organic matter, compost, manure to the top of your bed, composted manure. And then there's a couple different ways to plant your seeds. One way that I see people do it is just in a single row. So this row back here is about a foot wide, and this one's about 3 foot wide. If you make beds in your garden just 1 foot wide, you're gonna have a lot of path space in your garden and less garden space. So I like to use these wider beds. Also, some people just plant a single row of whatever they're growing in the garden. And then you're gonna have a bunch of weeds growing here and only a few carrots. Another way to plant that I like to do is just spread the seeds out like this and fill up your entire bed. And that crowds out the weeds and just gives you more vegetables and allows you to fill up your garden. If you are really precise, you could use something like a square foot guide, and the different holes are for different crops because some need more space than others. And so you can use this to figure out exactly how far to plant everything. If you do this, then you'll do less thinning. If you plant carrots like I showed you, just spreading them out, you're going to end up doing a lot of thinning later. You also need to buy bigger seed packets if you're going to plant like that, because you won't have enough seeds in a small packet that you buy from the grocery store. Another thing you can do is to soak your peas and beans. That's really gonna speed up your germination of your peas and bean seeds. So I soaked these for about a day, and then I'll probably shave at least a few days off their germination time. Another thing I did was I inoculated them, and this will help them fix a lot of nitrogen. So it's basically free fertilizer. So those are some things to remember when you're planting your garden in the spring and direct seeding. And I hope to see you next week. We're going to be talking more about drip irrigation and some other things about setting up your garden and planting here in the garden. That's all for today.